Wolves have been finding their way back to Colorado after being absent from the landscape for years, and they have also found their way into plans for reintroduction by Colorado Parks and Wildlife. In this video series, we will explore the past, present, and future of wolves in Colorado to learn more about how this species will be introduced and what it means for Colorado. From the lynx to the lesser prairie chicken, reintroduction has played a major part in restoring the biodiversity of our ecosystems. But what exactly is reintroduction and why is it even necessary to begin with? Before we had wildlife and land management agencies like Colorado Parks and Wildlife, the United States Fish and Wildlife Service, or the Forest Service, a lack of protection meant many species across the country faced threats to their survival from habitat loss, market hunting, and even the systematic removal of some species, such as wolves. These practices led to declines in species populations and even extirpation in some places. Things changed, however, both thanks to new wildlife and land management agency protections and the voices of those who didn't want to lose these important pieces of our vital and cherished ecosystems. Efforts began to focus on restoring healthy wildlife populations. As we work to support the reintroduction of different species, reintroduction is just one tool biologists use to help the ecosystems regain balance. Without reintroduction efforts, we may not have species like the black-footed ferret or even elk in Colorado today. So, what is the process of a reintroduction? Reintroduction is the process of putting an animal back into an area where they once lived but are no longer found, or helping to stabilize a population that is no longer healthy. This might sound simple, but the truth is, reintroducing an animal is hard work that involves not only sound research about the species, but a lot of conversations among different groups of people that may be affected by the reintroduction. From a scientific perspective, reintroduction requires biologists to gather a lot of information. It is important to know why a species is declining or is no longer in an area, what the species needs to survive, including its food, water, shelter, and space, where these animals will come from, and where they will go. Most importantly, we need to monitor the animals to know if the reintroduction was successful and determine how well the species reestablishes itself. While reintroducing a species requires a lot of work, it is something Colorado Parks and Wildlife and its partners have been doing for decades. Let's check out a couple of these success stories. Beginning in 1978, Colorado Parks and Wildlife reintroduced river otters back to their native riparian habitats. After unregulated fur trapping, habitat loss, and water pollution reduced their population numbers. Today, river otters in Colorado can be seen more often, having been changed from endangered to threatened thanks to reintroduction efforts. Another species that has made a comeback thanks to reintroduction efforts is the Canada lynx. Similar to gray wolf reintroductions, the lynx was a high-profile reintroduction of a carnivore species. Lynx are a secretive animal that are larger than a bobcat, but smaller than a mountain lion. Found in dense coniferous forests with a thick understory, lynx search for their favorite prey, the snowshoe hare. Unregulated trapping, widespread predator poisoning, and habitat loss due to logging and other development are thought to have contributed to the decline of the lynx in Colorado through the 1900s. In the 1970s, the last known lynx in Colorado was illegally trapped and killed. Almost 30 years later, in 1999, Colorado Parks and Wildlife worked on a reintroduction plan which successfully restored lynx back into the San Juan Mountains. Between 1999 and 2006, over 200 Canada lynx were reintroduced into Colorado by Colorado Parks and Wildlife. In 2010, monitoring efforts showed a self-sustaining lynx population on the ground, surviving and reproducing on their own. This achievement marked the first successful reintroduction of the species in the United States. You may be wondering, how do we determine the best way to release animals into the wild? While many factors are looked at, including the animal's stress, body condition, behavior, and specific needs, Our biologists also look at past reintroductions, the location, and the timing of the release when deciding the best method. Each species' reintroduction effort may look different because of these differing factors. The knowledge and experience gained by Colorado Parks and Wildlife during the lynx reintroduction, along with many other past successful reintroductions, is a valuable resource as we work on gray wolf restoration efforts in Colorado. We know that the balance of biological and social factors are key components to successful reintroduction. Good science, funding, political support, and the consideration of the public's questions and concerns must all come together for a reintroduction to be successful. Moving forward in this series, we'll dive into each of these key components and explore what they mean for Coloradans and the gray wolf. Thank you for joining us as we journey through a successful reintroduction plan that allows the gray wolf to successfully coexist with people here in Colorado.